Arguing against globalization is like arguing against the laws of gravity, said Kofi Annan, former Secretary General of the United Nations. The forces of globalization are now stronger than ever. And with this development, it is becoming increasingly important to be able to communicate with others in more than one language. This trend resonates with my passion, which is helping others become proficient in English. I find the project on field of English very rewarding to the extent that I feel like I can do this for the rest of my life. Back in 2011, my family moved to a town called New Malden in England, located just 20 kilometers southwest of London. Near the end of my time in England, due to a minor problem of housing contract, my parents and I had to relocate at the home of my mother's friend, Mrs. Kim. This was when my passion for education first aroused. During my 6-month stay there, I had the precious opportunity to help Mrs. Kim's daughter study both English and Korean. Teaching another human being how to read, write, speak, and listen in two different languages gave me a sense of achievement and self-worth that I never felt before in my life. By the time I left England, my passion for education had become an indispensable part of my identity. Once I was back in Korea, I decided to utilize my forte, English, for the working of others, and fortunately, I soon found an opportunity to do so in a club called Volume in my high school. This organization carries out volunteer services in a child development center, and I've been teaching English and other related subjects once a week to students of all age groups. In addition, I've also been participating in a project in which I visit children from single parents' households once a month and serve as an educator for them. Furthermore, I've been translating Korean fairy tales so that children in Southeast Asia can learn English by reading traditional books. To be frank, although rewarding, teaching a foreign language is by no means an easy task. Students often get frustrated when they feel they are far too behind, and sometimes others give up because they just don't get it. Not only do I perform the task of educating others on the field of English, but I also serve as a bridge that connects students to completely new territory called English. Doing so is especially difficult with mentally challenged children, for whom I must devise special lessons with smaller steps and extra details. Sometimes people ask me why I make myself go through all these. The answer is clear and simple. Sharing what I know with students and helping them in the process bring me immense feelings of joy and accomplishment. At the end of each lesson, I go home tired, yet elated by the fact that I brought students to closer to mastering English. As much as my students learn from me, I also learn from my students. I have the opportunity to hone and polish my skills, and I get to develop virtues like patience, tolerance, and intersectional understanding along the way. Even with the fourth industrial revolution, the experts agree that the field of education will remain free through the influence of the automation. In fact, quality education will become important than ever, since people need to develop unique skills to survive in this ever-changing society. I think that although teaching foreign language is a difficult job, but I believe that my passion and belief will be able to change others. Thank you.